Oh, you sure ain't fast, Mr. Keel.
I ain't gonna get you anywhere, boy. Tell my daughter I went home.
All right.
Roast beef today, and it was very tasty here.
Well, why didn't you wait for Tom? He only went for a little walk.
I suppose he'd mind if I filled my pipe.
Oh, help yourself.
Oh, and why don't you take some apples? You should always have some fruit in your room. Go ahead.
No, I wouldn't think of it.
Oh, that must be Mr. Halstead. Father, why don't you move in with us? I often wonder if you're eating.
I'm eating. See you soon, Captain.
Good evening.
Oh, Peter, it's you. I thought you might be Mr. Halstead.
How are you tonight, Catherine?
Mr. Keel.
Marana?
Oh, you mustn't mind him, dear. He's getting terribly old. Wouldn't you like some supper?
No. No, thanks.
He just sort of dropped by, Peter.
Well, that's all right. I can't take hot food in the evening anyway. I'll stick to my tea and toast. It's much healthier. And more economical.
You sound as though Tom and I threw money out the window.
Oh, not you, Catherine. He wouldn't be home, would he?
Well, he went for a little walk with the boys.
Don't you think that's dangerous right after dinner? Oh, that sounds like my brother.
Well, Tom, he would knock on his own door, would he? Oh, Mr. Halstead, come in, please.
Sorry I'm late. I was held up at the printing shop. Well, good evening, Your Honor.
Halstead, on business, no doubt.
Partly. It's about an article for the paper.
Oh, I don't doubt it. I understand my brother has become a very prolific contributor to, what do you call it? The People's Daily Liberator.
The People's Daily Messenger, sir. The doctor sometimes honors the messenger when he wants to uncover the real truth of some subject.
The truth? Oh, yes, I see.
Wouldn't you like something to eat?
Oh, no, thank you.
I don't want you to think I blame the doctor for using your column. After all, every performer goes for the audience that applauds him most. No, it's a... Not your paper I have anything against, Mr. Halstead.
Well, I really didn't think so, Your Honor.
As a matter of fact, I rather enjoy the spirit of tolerance in this town. Magnificent. Just don't forget that we have it because we all believe in the same thing. It brings us together.
Kirsten, spring, you mean?
The springs, Mr. Halstead, are wonderful new springs. Mark my words, Kirsten Springs are going to put us on the map. There's no doubt about it.
Oh, that's what Tom always says, too.
Everything is zooming ahead. Real estate going up, money changing hands every hour, business coming.
And no more unemployment.
Right. Give us a really good summer, and sick people will be coming here in carloads. We'll become a regular fad, a new Carl's fad. And for once, the well-to-do people won't be the only ones paying taxes in this town.
Well, I hear reservations are really starting to come in.
Coming in every day. It looks very promising, very promising.
Well, that's fine. Then the doctor's article will come in handy.
He's written something again.
No, it's a piece he wrote during the winter, recommending the water. But at the time, I let the article lie.
Why? Some kitchen?
Oh, no. I just thought it would have a greater impact in the spring when people start planning for the summer.
Very smart, Mr. Halstead. Very smart.
Tom is always so full of ideas about the spring.
Well, he ought to be. The spring pays his salary, my dear.
Oh, I think it's more than that. Well, don't you? Dr. Stockman created Kirsten Spring.
You don't say. Well, I have been hearing that lately, but I did think I had a certain modest part.
Well, Tom always says he...
I only meant the original idea was Dr. Stein.
My good brother is never at a loss for ideas, all sorts of ideas. But when it comes time to put them into action, you need another kind of man. And I didn't think that at least the people in this house might recognize that.
But, Peter, dear, we didn't mean... Mr. Halstead, go get yourself a bite. My husband will be with you any minute.
Well, thank you. Maybe just a little something.
Isn't it remarkable? Why is it that people without background can never learn tact?
Why upset yourself, Peter? Can't you and Thomas share the honors like good brothers?
The problem is that certain men are never satisfied to share.
Nonsense. You and Tom have always gotten along beautifully. Well, that must be there now.
Well, Catherine, here's another guest for you. Here's a hanging for your coat, Captain.
I know, Keith.
Oh, that's right, you don't wear an overcoat. You go on in, boy. You kids must be hungry all over again. Oh, Captain, I want you to get a look at this roast.
Tom, dear.
Oh, say, Peter. Well, now, this is really nice.
I'll have to go in a minute.
Oh, nonsense. Not with a toddy on the table. You haven't forgotten the toddy, have you, Catherine?
Of course not. I've got the water boiling.
Toddy, too?
Well, sure. Just make yourself at home.
Oh, no, I don't go in for drinking toddy.
But this is no party.
What else do you call it? It's extraordinary how much you people can consume and still live.
Well, why? What's finer than to watch young people eat? You know, Peter, those are the people that are going to stir up the whole future.
Is that so? Well, what is there to stir up?
Well, don't worry. They'll let us know when the time comes. And then old idiots like you and I will be left behind.
Well, I've never been called that before.
Jump up here every minute, will you, Peter? You know you're in trouble. Your impressions are blunted. You ought to sit up there in the corner of the north for 5 years like I did and then come back down here. Why, it's like watching the first 7 days of creation.
Here.
Well, sure. Things to work and fight for, Peter. Without that, you're dead.
Now, Catherine, are you sure the mailman came today?
There wasn't any mail today.
And that's another thing, Peter. A good income. Why, that's something you learn to appreciate after you've lived on a starvation diet.
When did you start?
Down here. You know, it was pretty tough going a lot of the times up there. But now, to be able to live like a prince. We'll take tonight, for instance. We had roast beef for dinner, and by God, there's enough left for supper, too. Oh, have a piece. Come here.
Please. No, no, no. Certainly not.
Well, at least let me show it to you. Why, we even had a tablecloth.
I saw it.
Live to the hilt. That's my motto. Anyway, Catherine says I'm earning almost as much as we spend.
Well, you're improving.
That was a joke, Peter. You're supposed to laugh. Why can't I have the pleasure of having young, interesting people around me? You'll see when Hofstede comes in with...
Oh, yes, Hofstede. That reminds me. He told me he was going to print one of your articles.
One of my articles?
Yes, about the spring. The one he wrote during the winter. You wrote during the winter.
Oh, that one. Oh, well, in the first place, I don't want that one printed right now.
No. It sounded to me as though it would be very timely.
Under normal conditions, maybe so.
Well, what's abnormal about the conditions now?
I can't go into that, Peter. At least not tonight. There could be a great deal abnormal about conditions. Well, then again, that could be nothing at all.
Well, you've managed to sound mysterious. Is there anything wrong? Something you're keeping from me? Because I wish you'd remind yourself once in a while, Thomas, that I am chairman of the board of this prince, as well as mayor.
And I'd like you to remember that, too, Peter. Look, let's not get into each other's hair.
Oh, God, no. I'm not in the habit of getting into people's hair. But I'd just like to underline that everything concerning Kirsten Springs must be treated in a business-like way, through proper channels and dealt with by the legally constituted authorities. I can't allow anything done behind my back in a roundabout way.
So when did I ever do anything behind your back, Peter?
You have an ingrained tendency to go your own way, Thomas, and that simply cannot go on in a well-organized society. The individual really must subordinate himself to the overall, or more accurately, to the authorities who are in charge of the general welfare.
Well, that's probably so, Peter, but what the hell does that have to concern with me?
My dear Thomas, that is exactly what you will never learn. But you had better watch out, because someday you might pay dearly for it. Well, there, now I said it. Good night.
Are you out of your mind? You're absolutely on the wrong track.
I am usually not. Anyway, may I be excused? Goodbye, Catherine. Good evening, gentlemen.
He left.
Yes, he did, and thoroughly burned up.
What do you do to him now?
What does he want from me, Catherine? He can't expect me to give him an accounting of every move that I make, every thought that I think, until I'm ready to do it.
Why? What should you give him accounting of?
Just leave that to me, Catherine. It's peculiar to me when I did
something. After a meal like that, my God, you feel like a new man. This house is so...
The mayor certainly wasn't in a glowing mood tonight.
No, it's his stomach. He has a lousy digestion.
Well, I think two editors from the People's Messenger.
No, it's just that Peter is such a lonely man. Poor fellow, all he knows is official business and duties and then all that damn weak tea he pours into himself. Oh, Catherine, may we have the toddy?
I'm not getting it.
Oh, sit down, Prince. Captain Horster, a rare guest like you. Sit here, please. Sit down, Prince.
This used to be such an ugly house. Suddenly it's beautiful.
Great man.
Here you are. Hot toddy's for everyone.
Wonderful. Oh, and the cigars at it. You know where the box is. Morton, get my pipe. You know, I have a sneaking suspicion that I live for snitching a cigar now and then, but I don't pay any attention. Oh, dear, do you know what, please?
I've got it.
Oh, he's got it. Good boy. Good boy. You want to pass the cigars around, Islip? Help yourself to the cigars, fellas. I'll stick to the pipe. Wilson's been through a lot of blizzards with me up in the north. Skull. Home. What an adventure, eh?
Will you be sailing soon, Captain Horst? Augustus?
I expect to be ready next week.
Oh, and then on to America?
Yes, that's the plan.
Although you won't be home for the new election.
Is there going to be another election?
Don't you know?
No, I don't get mixed up in those things.
But you are interested in public affairs.
Frankly, I don't understand anything about it.
Oh, neither do I, Captain. Maybe that's why I'm always so glad to see you.
Just the same, you ought to vote.
Even if I don't understand anything about it.
Understand? What do you mean by that? Society captain, like a ship. Every man should do his part to help navigate the ship.
That may be all right, I'm sure. But on board a ship, it doesn't work out so well.
Good evening.
Well, good evening, Petra.
And here you all are lying around like lizards while I'm out slaving.
Well, you come and be a lizard, too. You know, I look at her sometimes and I say to myself, how did I do it?
Fine young woman. Shall I mix a tonic for you?
Thank you. I had better do it myself. You always mix it too strong. Oh, Father, I forgot. I have a letter for you.
Who's it from?
I met the mailman on my way to school this morning, and he gave me your mail, too. And I just didn't have time to run back.
You don't give it to me until now?
I really didn't have time to run back.
If she didn't have time,
Yes. Let me see it. Come on. Oh, yes, indeed.
Was that the one you've been waiting for?
I'll be right back. There wouldn't be a light out in my room, would there?
The lamp is on the desk, burning away.
Please excuse me for a moment.
What's that, Mother?
I don't know. The last couple of days, he has been asking again and again about the mailman.
Probably an out-of-town patient of his.
Poor Father. He's got much too much to do. This ought to taste good.
By the way, what happened to that English novel you were going to translate for?
I started, but I got so busy.
Oh, you've been teaching evening school again?
Yes, 2 hours a night.
Plus high school every day?
Yes, 5 hours. And every night, a pile of lessons to correct.
She never stopped going.
Maybe that's why I always think of you as kind of breathless and, well, breathless.
I love it. I get so wonderfully tired.
She looks tired.
You must be a wicked woman, Petra.
Wicked?
You work so much. My teacher says that work is a punishment for our sins.
Oh, do you believe that?
I do. Of course you believe.
Don't stop the kid from speaking.
Don't you like one?
Work? No.
Then won't you ever mock you in this world?
Me? I'm going to be a Viking.
You can't do that, me.
So be Ethan.
I think it's getting late.
I agree with you, Morgan.
You certainly don't.
Yes, if I gotta do, I'm a real heathen and proud of it. You'll see. One day we're all going to be heathens.
And then we can do anything we want.
Right.
See, don't you have any homework for tomorrow, boys? Better go in and do it.
Aw, can't we stay out here for a while?
No, neither of you. Now run along.
Good night. Good night. And I don't have any homework.
Good night.
You don't think it hurts them to listen to such talk, do you?
I don't know, but I don't like it. What's
all? Boys, there's going to be news in this town.
News?
Oh, a terrific discovery, Captain.
Oh, really?
Well, that I made. Oh, now that the baboons running this town call me a lunatic. Well, now they'd better watch out. Oh, how the mighty have fallen.
What is it, Father?
Oh, if Peter were only here. Well, now you'll see how human beings can walk around and make judgments like blind rats.
Well, then the world's happened now.
Well, now, it is the general opinion, isn't it, that our town is a sound and healthy spot?
Of course.
What happened?
Even an unusually healthy spot? Oh, God, a place that can be recommended not only to all people, but to sick people.
Oh, but Don, what you can't.
I've recommended it. I myself have written and written about it to the people's messengers.
Yes, sir. But what are you trying to say?
Now the blessed, miraculous springs that cost such a fortune to build. The whole health institute is a pest hole.
No, my God.
Yes, you know that junk up in Wilmer Valley? That stuff that has such a stinking smell to it. When it comes down from the tannery up there, and the whole damn poisonous mess comes right out into the water that we're supposed to use to cure people with.
You mean actually where our beaches are?
Yes, exactly.
So how are you so sure about this, Doctor?
Well, I had a suspicion about it a long time ago. Last summer there were too many sick cases amongst the visitors, typhoid and gastric disturbances.
Oh, that did happen. I remember.
Well, yes, dear. Well, at the time we thought the visitors brought the bug. But last winter I got a new idea and I started investigating the water.
Well, so that's what you've been working on?
Yes, I sent a sample of the water to the university for an exact chemical analysis.
And that's what you've received.
This is it. It proves the existence of infectious organic matter in the water.
Well, thank God you discovered it in time.
Well, yes, I think we can say that, dear.
Oh, isn't it wonderful?
What do you intend to do now, Doctor?
Well, put the thing right, of course.
Do you think that can be done?
Well, if not, the whole institute is useless. But don't worry, friends. I am quite clear on what has to be done.
Oh, but Tom, why'd you keep it so secret?
What did you want me to do? Run around town and shoot my mouth off before I really knew? No, thanks. I'm not that crazy, dear. You know, you just don't understand what this means. The whole water system has got to be changed.
The whole water
system? The whole water system. The intake is much too low. It's got to be raised to a much higher spot. The whole construction's got to be ripped out.
Well, Father, at least you can prove they should have listened to you.
I sure remember.
That's right. You did warn them.
But of course I warned them. When they said started the damn thing, I told them not to build it down there. But who am I, a mere scientist, to tell politicians what to build their houses to do? Well, now they're going to get it both barrels.
This is tremendous. The doctor is a great man.
Oh, it's bigger than tremendous. Wait till they see this. Oh, Petra, my report is on my desk. And General Catherine. Oh, gentlemen, this final proof from the university. And, of course, my report. 5 solid explosive pages.
Please, speak it up.
Yes, dear. Right to the board of directors. Give this to me. What's her name again?
Randina, dear. Randina.
Yes, Randina. Tell our darling Randina to wipe her nose and run that over to the mayor right away. What's the matter, dear?
I don't know.
What's Uncle Peter going to say to
that? That's what I was wondering.
Well, what can he say? You know, he ought to be damn glad that such an important fact is brought up before we start an epidemic. Hurry, dear.
I'd like to put a brief item about this discovery in the mess.
Well, yes, now I'd be really grateful
for the public on it also.
Right away.
By God, you'll be the leading man in this town, Doctor.
Well, there was nothing to it. Every detective gets a lucky break once in his life. Still, just the same, I ought to...
Say, Hofstad, don't you think the town ought to pay Doctor's documents a trip?
No, no, no.
Let's all put in a word for Doctor.
I'll talk to Oswald.
Oh, no, no, I'll put it around, fellas. I won't stand for any emotion. You know, even if the board of directors decides to give me an increase, I won't take it. I just won't take it, Catherine.
That's right, Tom.
Skull, Father.
Skull, Father.
Doctor, I hope this brings you great honor and pleasure.
Thanks, friends, thanks. You know, there is one blessing above all others, and that's to have earned the respect of one's neighbors is... Well, it's... Oh, Catherine, I think I'm going to death.
Hey!
Chased me out like a dog. Jackasses out of all of them, Scott.
Yeah, they're
If you can get the mayor and his elegant friends to grant at this thing, I'll give a couple hundred crowns to charity. And right now, right on the spot.
Oh, that'd be very kind of you.
I haven't got much to play around with, but if you can pull the rug out from under him with this cockroach business, I'll give at least 50 crowns to charity. Maybe that'll teach him to put some brains back.
Good morning, Eddie Hall.
Oh, pardon me.
Come on in.
Oh, this one is in on it, too?
What's that, sir?
Of course he's in on it.
Oh, couldn't I have guessed? And it's going to be in the papers, I suppose. You're sure tying down the corners, aren't you? Well, lay it on thick. I've got to go.
Oh, no, no, no. Stay. Let me explain it to you.
Oh, I get it. Don't worry. Only you can see the...
That's the best idea I ever heard in my life.
Oh, my God. You don't understand about that.
Oh, the old badger doesn't believe a word of it.
What does he think you're doing?
Trying to make an idiot out of my brother, imagine.
Well, have you got a few minutes?
Sure, as long as you like.
Have you heard from the mayor?
Only that he's coming over later.
Well, I've been thinking about this since last night.
You know what's that?
For you as a medical man, well, scientist, this is a really rare opportunity. But I've been wondering if you realize it ties in with a lot of other issues.
What do you mean? Sit down. What are you driving at?
Well, you said last night that the water comes from impurities in the ground.
It comes from the poisonous dump in Windmill Valley.
Doctor, I think it comes from an entirely different dump. The same dump that's been poisoning and polluting our whole social life in this town.
For God's sake, Austin, what are you babbling about?
Well, everything that matters in this town is in the hands of a few bureaucrats.
Now, they're not all bureaucrats.
Well, they're all rich, all with old reputable names, and everything they want in the palm of their hands.
Yes, but they happen to have ability and knowledge.
Well, did they show ability and knowledge when they built the water system where they did?
No, of course not. But that happened to be a blunder, and we'll clear it up now.
And you imagine it's going to be as easy as all that?
Well, easy or not easy, it's got to be done.
But, Doctor, I've made up my mind to give this whole scandal very special treatment.
No, wait, you can't call it a scandal.
Oh, Doctor, when I took over the People's Messenger, I swore I'd blow that smug cabal of old, stubborn, self-satisfied fogies to bits. And this is the story that can do it.
Yes, but I still think we owe them a deep debt of gratitude for building the spring.
The mayor being your brother, I wouldn't ordinarily want to touch it. But I know you'd never let that kind of thing obstruct the truth.
No, of course not.
Well, I want you to understand me. I don't have to tell you I come from a simple family, but I know in my bones what the underdog needs. He's got to have a say in the government of society. Well, that's what brings out ability, intelligence, and self-respect.
Yes, I understand. Come in!
And I think that any newspaper man who denies the chance to give the underdog a lift, well, he's taking on a responsibility that I don't want. And I know perfectly well that in fancy circles they call it education. Well, they can call it anything they like if it makes them happy. But, Doctor, I have my own.
Yes, I agree with you, Hauser, but this is simply the water supply.
Mr. Osloxen's here.
I beg your pardon, Doctor, if I intrude.
Well, you're looking for me, Mr. Osloxen.
No, I didn't know you were here. I want to see the doctor.
No, what can I do for you?
Is it true what I hear from Mr. Billing that you intend to campaign for a better water system?
Yes, for the Institute, but it's not a campaign.
I just wanted to call and tell you that we are behind you 100%.
Well, there, you see?
Well, now I really appreciate having the publisher of a newspaper behind
you. We can be important, Doctor. When the little man wants to push something through, he turns out to be the majority, you know? And it's always good to have a majority on your side.
Well, yes, that's certainly true, Mr. Osloxen, but I don't see what all this is about. It seems to me it's a simple, straightforward business. The water is...
Of course, we intend to behave with moderation, Doctor. I always try to be a moderate and careful man.
You are known for that, Mr. Osloxen.
Kirsten Springs is becoming a gold mine for this town, especially for the little businessman. And that's why, in my capacity as chairman of the Property Owners Association,
yes.
And furthermore, as a representative of the Temperance Society, you probably know, Doctor, that I am active for prohibition.
Yes, so I've heard.
As a result, I come into contact with all kinds of people. And since I'm known to be a law-abiding and solid citizen, I have a certain influence in this town. You might even call it a little power.
I know that very well, Mr. Osloxen.
So you can see that it would be practically nothing for me to arrange a demonstration.
A demonstration? But what are you going to demonstrate about?
Oh, the people of this community complimenting you for bringing this important matter to our attention. Obviously, it would have to be done with the utmost moderation so as not to hurt the authority.
Now, this could knock the big belly right into the garbage can.
No indiscretion or extreme aggressiveness from the authorities, Mr. Hostead. I don't want any wild-eyed radicalism on this thing. I've had enough of that in my time, and no good ever comes of it. But for a good, solid citizen to express his calm, frank and free opinion is something nobody can deny.
Oh, my dear Mr. Osmundson, I can't tell you how it heartens me to hear this kind of support. I'm happy, I really am. Oh, say, wouldn't you like me down to Sherry?
I am a member of the Temperance Society.
A glass of beer, then.
I don't think I can go quite that far, Doctor. Well, good day. And I want you to remember that you have a little man behind you like a wall. You have the solid majority on your side. Because the little man decided...
Yes, thanks for that, Mr. Osmundson. Good day.
Are you going to the printing shop, Mr. Hofstad?
No, I just have a thing or two to attend to here.
Very well, then.
Well, what do you say to a little hypodermic for these fence-sitting deadheads? Everybody's afraid. Afraid. They know perfectly well what's right, but they're afraid.
Well, why? I thought Mr. Osmundson a very sincere man.
Well, isn't it time we pump some guts into these well-intentioned men of goodwill? Under all their liberal talk, they still idolize authority, and that's got to be rooted out of this town. This blunder of the water system has to be made clear to every voter. Let me print your report.
Not until I talk to my brother.
Well, I'll write an editorial in the meantime, and if the mayor won't go along.
I don't see how you can imagine such a thing.
Oh, believe me, Doctor.
Now listen, I promise you, he will go along with it, and then you can print my report. Every word of it.
On your word of honor?
Well, look, here it is. Take it. It can't hurt for you to read it. Just return it to me later.
Good day, Doctor.
Good day. And you'll see it's going to be much easier than you think.
I hope so, Doctor. Sincerely. Let me know as soon as you hear from his honor.
Oh, Catherine!
Mr. Halstead.
Good morning.
Oh, you're home already, Petra.
I just got back from school. Oh, hasn't he been here yet?
Who, Peter? No, but I just had a long chat with Halstead, and you know, he's really fascinated with my discovery. It seems there are many more implications than I thought at first. Do you know what I have backing me up?
Oh, what in heaven's name have you got backing
me up? Quite a solid majority. Oh, that must be Peter. Come in!
Well, solid majority, is that good?
Good! It's wonderful! You just don't know how it feels, Catherine, to know your whole town feels like a brother to you. Why, I haven't felt so at home in this town since I was a boy.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's nice to see you, Peter.
How are you today?
Well, so-so. I received your thesis yesterday upon the condition of the spring.
Yes, I got your note.
Did you read it?
I read it. And what do you have to say?
Come on.
Thomas, was it really necessary to go into this investigation behind my back?
Oh, well, yes, until I was really convinced of myself, there was no point.
And now you are convinced.
Well, yes, of course. Aren't you too, Peter? The university chemist corroborated my theory.
You intend to present this document to the board of directors officially as the medical officer of the spring.
Well, yes, of course. Something's got to be done, and quick.
Oh, Thomas, you always use such strong expression. Among other things, in your report, you say that we guarantee our guests and visitors a permanent case of poisoning.
Yes, but Peter, how can you describe it any other way? Imagine poisoned internally and externally.
And so you merrily conclude that we must build a waste disposal plant and reconstruct a brand new water system from the bottom up.
What? Do you know some other way out? I don't.
I took a little walk to the city engineer's office this morning. And in the course of conversation, I kind of jokingly mentioned these changes as something we might consider for the future.
The future won't be soon enough, Peter.
Well, the engineer kind of smiled at my extravagance and gave me some facts. I don't suppose you've taken the trouble to consider what your proposed changes would cost.
No, I didn't think of that.
Naturally, your little project would come to at least 300,000 crowns.
That expensive.
Oh, don't be upset. It's only money. The worst thing is that it would take some 2 years.
2 years?
Yes, at the very least. And what do you propose we do about the springs in the meantime? Shut them up, no doubt. Because we have to, you know. As soon as the rumor gets around that the water is dangerous, we won't have a visitor left. And that's the picture, Thomas. You have it in your power to literally ruin your own town.
Well, now look, I don't want to ruin anything.
Thomas, your report has not convinced me that the conditions are as serious as you try to make them.
Well, listen, they are even more serious than the report makes them out to be. Remember, summer is coming and the warm weather.
I think you're exaggerating. A capable physician ought to know what precautions to take.
And then what?
Thomas, the water supplies for the springs are a fact, and they've got to be treated as a fact. Now, if you are reasonable and act with discretion, the board of directors will be inclined to take into consideration any means to reasonably, and without financial sacrifices, make possible improvements.
Dear God, do you really think for 1 minute that I would ever agree to such trickery?
Trickery?
Yes, a trick, a fraud, a lie, a treachery, a downright crime against the public and against the
whole community. I said before, I'm not convinced there is any actual danger.
Good, you are. Well, anything else is impossible. My report is an absolute fact. You know your trouble, Peter. It's you and your administration that decided to build the water supply where you did, and now you're afraid to admit the blunder you committed. Damn it, don't you think I can see through it all?
Well, let's suppose that's true. Maybe I do care a little about my reputation. I still say I do it for the good of the town. Without moral authority, there can be no government. And that is why, Thomas, it is my duty to prevent your report from reaching the board. Sometime later, I'll bring up the matter for discussion. In the meantime, not a single word is to reach the public.
My dear Peter, do you really think you can prevent that?
It will be prevented.
Can be. Too many people already know about it.
Who? Well, you can't possibly be those people from the Daily Mess.
Exactly. The liberal, free, and independent press will stand up and do its duty.
Thomas, you are an unbelievably irresponsible person. Can't you imagine what consequences this will have for you?
For me?
For you and your whole family.
Oh, what the hell are you saying now?
I believe I have the right to think of myself as a helpful brother.
You have, Ben, and I thank you deeply for it.
Don't mention it. I often couldn't help myself. I had hoped that by improving your finances, I would be able to keep you from running completely hog wild.
So you mean it was only for your own sake?
Partly, yes. What do you imagine people think of an official whose closest relatives keep getting themselves into trouble time and time again?
That's what I've done.
You do it without knowing it. You're like a man with an automatic brain. As soon as an idea pops into your head, no matter how idiotic it may be, you get up like a sleepwalker and start writing a pamphlet.
Yes, but Peter, don't you think that it's a citizen's duty to share a new idea with the public?
The public doesn't need any new ideas. The public is much better off with old ideas.
Did you not even embarrassed to say that?
Now look, I'm going to lay this out once and for all. You're always barking about authority. A man gives you an order, he's persecuting you. Nothing is important enough for you to respect once you decide to revolt against your superior. Well, all right. I do. I'm not going to try to change you anymore. I told you the stakes you're playing for here. And now I'm going to give you an order. And I'm warning you, you had better obey it if you value your career.
What kind of an order?
You are going to deny these rumors officially.
How?
Simply say that you looked into the examination of the water more thoroughly and you find that you had overestimated the danger.
I see.
And that you had complete confidence that whatever improvements are needed, the management will certainly take care of it.
My convictions come from the conditions of the water. My convictions will change when the water changes and for no other reason.
What are you talking about, convictions? You're an official. You keep your convictions to yourself.
To myself?
As an official, I said. As a private person, that is something else. But as a private employee and a subordinate employee of the Institute, you have no right to express any convictions or personal opinions about anything connected with power.
Now, you listen to me. I am a doctor and a scientist.
What has this got to do with science?
And I have the right to express my opinion on anything in the world.
Not about the Institute. That I forbid.
You forbid.
I forbid you as your superior. And when I give you orders, you obey.
Oh, Peter, if you are my brother, I swear.
I'm going to stand for that. Petra.
What have you two been doing? Eavesdropping?
You were talking so loudly.
Yes, I was eavesdropping.
Well, that makes me very happy.
And you were saying something to me about forbidding.
You forced me to.
So you want me to spit in my own face officially, is that it?
Why must you always be so calm?
And if I don't obey?
Then we will publish our own statement to calm the public.
Good enough. And I will write against you. I will stick to what I said, and I'll prove that I am right and that you are wrong, and then what will you do?
Then I simply won't be able to prevent your dismissal. Dismissed from the Institute is what I said. If you want to make war on Pearson Springs, you have no right to be on the board of directors.
You would dare do that?
Oh, no, you're the daring man.
Uncle, this is a rotten way to treat a man like father. You be quiet, Petra.
So young, and already you have opinions. Well, it's only natural. Catherine, my dear, you're probably the only sane person in this house. Will you knock some sense into his head? Make him realize what he's driving his whole family.
My family concerns nobody but myself.
His family and his own town.
You know, I'm going to show you who loves this town, Peter. The people are going to get the full stink of this corruption, and then we'll see who loves this town.
You love your town. when you blindly, spitefully, stubbornly go ahead trying to cut off our most important industry.
But that's us as poisons, man!
We are getting fat by peddling filth and corruption to innocent people!
Thomas, this has gone beyond convictions and opinions. Any man who can throw that kind of insinuation around is nothing but a traitor to society.
How dare you!
I will not expose my cause of violence here. You have been warned. Consider what you owe yourself and your family. Good day.
He's insulted. He's insulted!
Shameful, Thomas. Oh, I would love to give him a piece of my mind.
It's my own fault. I should have shown my teeth right from the beginning. He called me a traitor to society. Me! Damn it all, that's not going to stick.
Please. Think he's got all the power on his side.
Yes, but I have the truth on mine.
Without power, what good is the truth?
Mother, how could you say such a thing?
Well, that's ridiculous, Catherine. I have the liberal press with me and the majority, the solid majority. If that's not power, what is?
But for heaven's sake, Tom, you aren't going to...
What? What am I not going to do?
You aren't going to fight it out in public with your brother.
Well, what the hell else do you want me to do?
It won't do you any earthly good. If they won't do it, they won't. All you get out of it is a notice that you're fired.
I'm going to do my duty, Catherine. Me, the man he calls a traitor to society.
And what about your duty to your family, the people you're supposed to provide for?
Don't always think of us first, Mother.
You can talk. If worse comes to worse, you can manage. But what about the boys, Tom, and you, and me?
Well, what about you? You want me to be the miserable animal who crawled the boots of that damn gang? Will you be happy if I can't face myself for the rest of my life?
There is so much injustice in the world, you've simply got to learn to live with it. If you go on this way, God help us, we'll have no money again. Is it so long since the North that you have forgotten what it was to live like we live? Haven't we had enough of that in one lifetime? And what about them? We've got nothing if you are fired!
Stop it! Well, boys, what did you learn in school today?
We learned what an insect is.
You don't say.
What happened? Why is everybody...
Nothing. You know what I'm going to do, boys? From now on, I'm going to teach you what a man is.
The little businessmen and the whole town will be screaming for his head. Osloxen will see to that.
But the stockholders will have to lay out a fortune of money if this goes through.
My boy, I think it's going to bust them. And when the springs go busted, well, the people are finally going to realize what level of genius has been running this town. Those five sheets of paper are going to put in a liberal administration once and for all.
It's a revolution. You know that, don't you? I mean it. We're on the edge of a real revolution.
Put it on the press.
Mr. Osloxen, the doctor's here.
Wonderful. What did the doctor say?
The mayor declares war. So war is exactly what it's going to be. Do you know what he tried to do to me? He's actually got the nerve to blackmail me. He said that I am not allowed to speak my mind without his permission.
Well, he actually said it right out.
Right to my face. Of course, my trouble was I kept on giving them credit for being our kind of people. But they're dictators. They're people who hold on to power even if they have to poison the town to do it.
Now, take it easy, Doctor. You mustn't always be throwing accusations. I'm with you, understand. The moderation...
What did you think of the article, Hofstede?
Well, it's a masterpiece. In one blow, you've managed to prove beyond any doubt what kind of men are running us.
Maybe print it now, then.
I should say so.
Ready for tomorrow's paper.
Oh, and say, Mr. Hofstede, do me a favor, will you? You run a fine paper, but supervise the printing personally. I'd hate to see the weather report stuck in the middle of my article.
Oh, don't worry. There won't be a mistake this time.
Make it perfect. We're printing money, eh? Oh, I can tell you how I'm dying to see this in print. After all the lies in the papers, the half lies, the quarter lies, to finally see the absolute unvarnished truth about something important. And this is only the beginning. We'll go on to other subjects and we'll blow up every lie we live by. What do you say, S. Larson?
Well, just remember, moderation. I don't see what's so funny about that. Dr. Stockman, I feel as though I stand in some historic pain. Damn it, this is a historic day. Someday this scene will be in a museum titled The Day the Truth Was Born.
Yes, well, I have an appointment with a patient. I shouldn't be long.
I hope you realize how useful he could be to us.
I just don't like that business about this is only the beginning. Let him stick to the springs.
What makes you so scared all the time?
I have to live here. It'd be different if you were attacking the national government or something. But he thinks I'm going to start going after the whole town administration.
What's the difference? That is bad.
Yes, but there is a difference. You attack the national government, then what's going to happen? Nothing. They go right on. But a town administration, well, they're liable to be overthrown or something. I represent the small property owners of this town.
Ah, it's always the same. Give a man a little property and the truth can go to hell.
Mr. Miller, I'm older than you are. I've seen fire eaters before. And you know who used to work at this desk before you? Councilman Densford.
Councilman. Just because I worked at Renegade's desk, does that mean that you can...
You're a politician. And a politician never knows where he's going to end up. And besides, you applied for a job as secretary to the magistrate, didn't you?
Billy! Well, why not? If I get it, I'll have a chance to put across plenty of good things. I could put a lot of big boys on the spot with a job like that.
All right. I'm just saying, people change. Just remember when you call me a coward. I may not have made the hot speeches before, but I never went back on my beliefs. Unlike some of the big radicals around here, I didn't change. Of course, I am a little more moderate.
Oh, God.
I don't see what's so funny about that.
We could get rid of him. We could really put out
easy. He pays the printing bill. He's not that bad. Well, I'm going to get the printer on this.
Say, Hofstede, do you think we have Stockman to back us? We could really put out a paper.
What would he do for money?
His father.
Keel? Since when has he got any money?
I think he's loaded with it.
No. Really, as long as I've known him, he's worn the same suit, the same hat.
And the same ring on his right hand. Did you ever get a look at that boulder?
No, I never.
All year round, he wears the diamond on the inside. But on New Year's Eve, he turns it around. Figure it out. When a man has no visible means of support, what's he living on? Money, right?
Hello!
Well, fancy seeing you here. Sit down.
I want to ask you something.
What's that?
This English novel you want to translate.
Well, aren't you going to do it?
I don't get this.
You don't get what?
This book is absolutely against everything you people believe.
Oh, it isn't that bad.
But Mr. Hofstede, it says that if you're good, there's a supernatural force that'll fix it so you end up happy. And if you're bad, you'll be punished. Since when does the world work that way?
Yeah, but Petra, this is a newspaper. People like to read that kind of thing. Well, they buy the paper for that. Then we slip in our political stuff. A newspaper can't fuck the public.
You don't say.
Well, now, wait a minute. I don't want you to go feeling that way. Here, take this to the printer, will you?
Sure.
I just want you to understand something. I never even read that book. It was Billing's idea.
I thought he was a radical.
Well, he is, but he's also
a newspaper man.
Well, that too. But I was just going to say he's trying to get the job as secretary to the magistrate.
What?
People are people, Miss Stockman.
But the magistrate?
He's been trying to fight everything that's rest of in this town for 30 years.
Well, let's not argue about it. I just didn't want you to go out of here with the wrong idea of me. I guess you happen to know that I happen to admire women like you. And I never had a chance to tell you, but, well, I want you to know it. Do you mind?
No, I don't mind. But reading that book upset me. I really don't understand. Will you tell me why you're supporting my father?
What's the mystery? It's a matter of principle.
But a paper that'll print a book like that has no principle.
Why do you jump to such extremes? You're just like...
what?
Well, I simply...
my father you met. You really have no use for him, do you?
Well, now, wait a minute.
What's behind this? Are you just trying to hold my hand or something?
I happen to agree with your father. That's why I'm printing his stuff. Believe me, nothing would please me more than to hold your hand, Miss Stockman. But I assure
you... You're trying to put something over. Why are you in this?
Well, who are you accusing? Billings gave you that book, not me.
But you don't mind printing it, do you? What are you trying to do with my father? You have no principle. What are you up to here?
Halstead! Oh, Miss Stockman.
I don't think I've been so frightened in all my life.
Well, wait. Please, you must.
Where are you going? The mayor's out there.
The mayor?
He wants to speak to you. He came in the back door. He doesn't want to be seen.
What does he want?
Billy, go by the front door and watch for anyone coming in here.
Well, come in here, Otto.
Thank you. It's clean. I had always imagined that it would look dirty, but it's clean. Very nice, Mr. Osmerson.
Not at all, Your Honor. I mean to say...
Sit down, Your Honor. What can I do for you?
I had a very upsetting thing happen to me today, Mr. Halstead.
Is that so?
Yes, it seems that my brother has written some sort of a memorandum about the spring.
You don't say.
Oh, he showed it to you.
He said something about it.
That's it, isn't it?
I don't know. I haven't had a chance to read it yet. The printer just handed it to me.
Isn't that the thing the printer wants at the spelling check
now? Yes, that's it. It's just a question of the spelling. I'll be right back.
I'm very good at spelling. Maybe I can help.
No, Your Honor. There's some Latin in it. You wouldn't know Latin, would you?
Yes, I used to help my brother with his Latin all the time. Here, let me down. You're going to print this.
Well, I can't refuse a signed article. A signed article is the author's responsibility.
Mr. Osmond said that. You're going to allow it.
I'm the publisher, not the editor. My policy has always been freedom for the editor.
Yes, you have a point. I can see that.
So, if you don't mind...
Not at all. There's some reconstruction of the spring.
I realize, Your Honor, that it does mean tremendous sacrifices for the stockholders.
Oh, don't upset yourself. The first thing a mayor learns is that the less wealthy can always be prevailed upon to demand a spirit of sacrifice for the public good.
Well, I'm glad to see that.
Oh, yes. Especially when it's the wealthy who are doing the sacrificing. What you don't seem to understand, Mr. Osmerson, is that so long as I am mayor, any changes to those bands will be paid for by a municipal loan.
A municipal? You mean you're going to tax the people for this?
Exactly.
But the springs are a private corporation.
The corporation built the springs out of its own money. If the people want them changed, naturally, the people will have to pay the bill. The corporation is in no position to put out any more of its own money. It simply can't do it.
That's impossible. People will never stand for another tax. Is this a fact or your opinion?
It happens to be a fact. Plus another fact. You'll forgive me for speaking about facts in a newspaper office. Don't forget that it'll take 2 years to rebuild the springs. That's 2 years without any income for your small business men, Mr. Robinson. Plus a heavy new tax besides. And all because of this dream, this hallucination that we live in a pest hole.
That's based on science.
This is based on vindictiveness, on his hatred of authority and nothing else. This is a mad dream of a man who wants to blow up our way of life. It has nothing to do with science or reform or anything but pure and simple destruction. And I intend to see to it that the people understand it exactly so.
You sure you want to support this thing, Hofstad?
Well, frankly, I never thought of it quite that way. I mean, when you think about it psychologically, it's completely possible the man is simply out to... Well, I don't know what to say, Your Honor. I hate to hurt the town in any way. I never imagined there'd be a new tax.
Oh, well, you should have imagined it. Because you are going to have to advocate. Unless, of course, liberal and radical newspaper right readers and enjoy paying high taxes. You'd know that better than I. No, I happen to camp here. a brief story with the actual facts. It proves that with a little care, nobody need be harmed at all by the water. Of course, in time, there'd be some minor structural changes we'd have to make, and we'd pay for those.
May I see that?
I want you to study it, Mr. Hostin, and see if you're...
Are you expecting the doctor?
Is he here?
He's just crossing the street.
I'd rather not run into him here. How can I...
Right this way, sir. Hurry up.
Yeah, hurry up.
Hurry up.
Get him out of here right away.
Do something.
Any proofs yet? I guess not, huh?
No, you can't expect them for some time.
Well, do you mind if I wait?
We're pretty busy, Doctor, so if you don't mind...
Oh, that's the way to be. Busy, busy, busy. Don't let me get in the way. You know, we're going to make this town shine like a... Oh, just one more thing, though.
Couldn't we talk some other time?
Just two words, I was walking down the street right now, and looking at the people in the shops, and suddenly I was kind of touched, you know? By their innocence. What I'm driving at is that when this thing breaks, they're liable to start making a saint out of me or something. Anyway, Mr. Ross, looks like I want you to promise me you're not going to put me up for any dinner or anything like that.
Doctor, there's no use concealing
the fact. I simply will not attend a dinner in my honor.
Doctor, I think it's time we...
I thought so. Come if I want you home. Now come. I want you to talk to Petra.
What? What's the matter? What are you doing here?
Something wrong, Mrs. Stockman.
Dr. Stockman is the father of three children, Mr. Hostin.
Well, now everybody knows that, dear.
No one would believe it, by the way. You're dragging us into this disaster.
Oh, now, Mrs. Stockman.
He treats you like a son, and you want to make a fool out of him.
I'm not having a fool out of
him. He loses his job at the Springs. Do you realize that? You print the article, and they'll grind him up like a piece of flesh.
Catherine, you're embarrassing me. Please excuse me, gentlemen.
What are you up to, Mr. Hobbs?
I won't have you jumping in house, Catherine.
I want you home. This man is not your friend.
He is my friend. Any man who shares my risk is my friend. You just don't understand what's going to happen, Catherine. As soon as this breaks, the people are going to come out of the streets and they're going to drive that damn... What's this? What is he doing here?
All right, Rochelle, let's be
calm. What are you trying to do? Talk you out of it, Hobbs? Well, it's not going to work. Where are you hiding here?
Be careful, Doctor.
Oh, Peter... Well, poisoning the water wasn't good enough. Now you're working on the press, too, eh?
My hat, please, and my stick. Oh, what's this nonsense? Take that off. That's official insignia.
I just wanted you to realize, Peter, that any man may wear this hat in a democracy and that a free citizen is not afraid to touch it. As for your baton of command, Your Honor, well, it passes from hand to hand, so don't gloat yet. The people haven't spoken. And I have the people because I have the truth, my friend.
Doctor, we're not scientists. We're not able to judge whether your article is really true or not.
Print it under my name. Let me defend it.
I'm not printing it. Well, I'm not going to sacrifice this newspaper. When the whole story gets out, well, the public's not going to stand for any changes in the Springs.
His honor just told us, Doctor. You see, there'll have to be a new tab.
Oh, I see. So that's suddenly why you're not scientists and can't tell whether I'm telling the truth or not. Well, so...
Well, don't take that attitude. The point is...
The point? Well, the point is going to fly through this town like an arrow, and I'm going to fire it. Will you print this as a pamphlet? I'll pay for it.
Doctor, I'm not going to ruin this paper or this town. For the sake of your family.
You can leave his family out of this, Mr. Osloxen. God help me, I think you people are horrible.
My article, if you don't mind.
Doctor... You won't get it printed in this town.
Can't you forget it? Can't you see now?
I'm not going to forget it. And you will never forget it for as long as you live. I'm going to call a mass meeting, and I'm going to tell
them. Who will rent you a hall?
Well, then I'll get a drum, and they'll march from street to street, proclaiming that the Springs have evolved and that poison is rotting the body politic.
And I believe you really are that man.
Mad? Oh, my dear brother, you haven't even heard me raise my voice yet. Captain.
people, so some of you will probably have to stand.
My name is Billings. Don't you remember? At the doctor's house.
Oh, yeah, sure. I've been so busy I didn't recognize you. Why don't those people come inside?
I don't know. I guess they're waiting for the mayor or somebody important, so they can be sure it's respectable in here. I wanted to ask you a question before this begins, Captain. Why are you letting your house for this? I never heard of you connected with anything political before.
I'll answer that. I travel most of the year. Did you ever travel?
Not abroad, no.
Well, I've been to a lot of places where people aren't allowed to say unpopular things. Did you know that?
Sure. I read about it.
Well, I don't like it.
One more question. What's your opinion about the doctor's proposition to rebuild the springs?
Don't understand anything about it. Come in, come in. There's a few seats left, but some of you will probably have to stand.
Well, try your horn.
No, let them start to talk first.
When they hear this, I can blow your mustache off with this.
I don't want any rough hops, you hear me? Come in, come in. I've got a seat just for you.
There's quite a crowd on the sidewalk. Why don't they come in?
I suppose they're waiting for the mayor.
Are all of those people on his side?
Who knows? People are bashful. And it's so unusual to come to a meeting like this. I suppose they believe what they're ready.
Good evening, ladies. I don't blame you for not speaking, but I don't think this is going to be the place for ladies tonight.
I don't remember asking for your advice, Mr. Billings.
I'm not as bad as you think, Mrs. Stockman.
Then why did you print the mayor's statement and not a word about my husband's report? Nobody's had a chance to find out what he really stands for. Why, all the people out there are against him also.
If we had printed your husband's report, it would have only have hurt him.
Mr. Billings, I've never said this to anyone before in my life, but I think you're a liar.
You do that one more time, and I'll throw you out of here. Patrick. Petra.
Good evening.
Why so cold? He asked for a meeting, and he's gone. Isn't he here? The doctor is going around town to be sure that there's a good attendance.
Oh, fair enough.
Petra, was it you that painted that poster, the one someone stuck to the side of the town hall?
If you can call it a painting, yes.
You know, I could have you arrested for that. There's a law against defacing the town hall.
Well, here I am. If you arrest your leader, I'll never speak to you.
Oh, Catherine, you have no sense of humor.
Your Honor.
Right this way, gentlemen. Come on in. Sit down. There ought to be enough seats for everybody. But if not, you'll just have to stand. Now just relax. It shouldn't take long at all.
Well, it's good to see you. Good to see you're here, Peter.
Witness business for the world, Tom.
How do you do, Captain?
Just promise me, don't lose your temper.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, sit down. Sit down, please. Now, we might as well get started. Now, the issue is very simple.
Doctor, we haven't elected a chair.
I'm sorry, Mr. Oslickson. I advertised a lecture, not a meeting.
Well, I came to a meeting, Doctor. We've got to have some kind of control here.
What do you mean by control? What is there to control?
Sure, let him speak. This is no meeting.
Your Honor, why don't you take control?
Just a minute now.
Well, somebody responsible has got to take charge.
There's a big difference in opinion here.
What makes you so sure? You don't even know yet what I'm going to say.
I got a pretty good idea what you're going to say, and I don't like it. If a man doesn't like where he is, then he should go to the place that suits him better. We don't want any troublemakers here.
Well, just a minute, Frank. You don't know anything about me.
We know all about you, Stockman.
Oh, from what? From the newspapers? How do you know I don't like this town? I came here to save the life of this town.
Just a minute, Doctor. I think the democratic thing to do is to elect a chair.
I nominate the mayor. Second the mayor.
Oh, no. That wouldn't be fair. We need a neutral person. I'd like to suggest Mr. Oslickson.
Well, I came to a lecture. I didn't...
What are you afraid of, a fair fight?
Second, Mr. Oslickson. That's a very fine choice.
All right. That's your pleasure. I just want you people to realize that the reason I called for this lecture was I have a very important message for you people. And I couldn't fit it into the press, and nobody would write me a call.
Ah, sit down.
So we are not given time to speak here tonight. Mr. Oslickson.
I have just one word before we begin. Whatever is said here tonight, please remember, the highest civic virtue is moderation. Now, does anybody wish to speak? Does anybody want the floor?
Mr. Chair.
His Honor the Mayor will address the meeting.
Gentlemen and ladies, there's no reason this should take
take very long tonight, and we can return to our ordinary calm and peaceful lives. Here is the issue. My brother, Dr. Stockman, and believe me, it is not easy for me to say this, Dr. Stockman has decided to destroy Kirsten Springs, our college.
Peter! Let the mayor continue, please. There mustn't be any interruptions.
He has a long and very involved way of going about it, but that is the brunt of it, believe me.
Then what are we wasting time for? Run him out of town!
I want no violence here. I want you to understand his motives. He is a man, always has been, who is never happy unless he is battering authority, ridiculing authority, destroying authority. He wants to attack the Springs so he can prove the administration blundered in the construction.
May I speak? I think
the mayor's not finished.
Thank you. Now we all remember what this town was like. And I know that there are some people here tonight who seem to think the doctor has the right to say anything he pleases. After all, we are a democratic country. God knows. In ordinary times, I agree 100% with anybody's right to say anything. But these are not ordinary times. Nations have crises, and so do towns. There are ruins of nations, and there are ruins of towns all over the world that were wrecked by men who, under the guise of reform and pleading for justice and so on, broke down all authority and left behind only revolution and chaos.
Now, what the hell are you saying?
I'll have to insist.
Now, just a minute. I didn't invite him to attack me. He's got the press in every hall in town to attack me, and I've got only this room tonight.
I don't think you're making a very good impression, Doctor. You may continue, Your Honor.
We all remember what this town was like before our institute. We could barely afford to keep the streets in condition. This was a dead, third-rate hamlet. Today, we are just on the verge of becoming internationally known as a resort. I predict that within 5 years, the income of every man in this room will be immensely greater. I predict our school will be bigger and better. And in time, our town will be crowded with fine carriages. Great homes will be built here. First-class stores will open all along Main Street. I predict that unless we are defamed and maliciously attacked, in time we will be one of the richest and most beautiful resort towns in the world. There you have your choice. Now all you have got to do is ask yourselves a simple question. Has any man the right, the democratic right, as they like to call it, to pick at the most minor flaws of the Springs, to exaggerate the most picayune faults?
No!
And to attempt to publish these defamations for the entire world to see? We live or die on what the outside world thinks of us. I believe there is a line that must be drawn. And if a man decides to cross that line, then we, the people, must finally grab him by the collar and declare, you cannot say that.
Yes, sir.
All right, then. I think we all understand each other here. Mr. Osmondson, I move that Dr. Stockman be prohibited from reading his report at this meeting.
Oh, yeah.
I think we're ready now to proceed to the vote.
No, aren't you going to let me speak at all?
Doctor, we're just about to vote on that.
But damn it, man, I have a right to...
Point of order, Bob.
Yes, point of order.
Yes, Doctor.
You want to discuss the motion.
That's right, Gambit. I want to discuss the motion.
All right, go ahead.
Now listen to me. He talks and he talks and he talks, but not a word about the facts.
We don't want to hear any more about the water.
You're just trying to blow up everything.
No, wait, judge for yourselves. Let me read.
No!
Uproar. Doctor, I think the majority wants to take the vote before you start to speak. If they so will, you may speak. Otherwise, majority rules. You won't deny that.
Don't bother voting. I understand everything now. May I have a few minutes,
Mr. Chairman?
No, I will not mention the Institute. I have a new discovery, 1,000 times more important than all the institutes in the world. May I have the platform?
I don't see how we can deny him, and as long as
the
he can
find himself... Now, before I go into my subject, I would like to thank the liberals and the radicals among us, like Mr. Hofstede.
What do you mean, radical? Where's your evidence to call me a radical?
Oh, you got me there. There is no evidence. In fact, there never really was. I just wanted to congratulate you on your self-control tonight. You who have fought in every parliament for the principle of free speech these many years.
Well, I believe in democracy. When my readers are overwhelmingly against something, well, I'm not going to impose my will upon the majority.
And you have just begun my remarks, Mr. Hofstede. Now, gentlemen, Mrs. Dunn, Miss Dunn. Tonight I was struck by a sudden flash of light, a discovery second to none. But before I go into it, a little story.
Doctor.
I spent a good many years in the north of our country. Man up there lives huddled together in little piles of stone. His whole life consists of grubbing for food, nothing more. And it occurred to me one day that it was romantic and sentimental for a man of my education to be tending these people. They had not yet reached a stage where they needed a doctor.
Is that the way you refer to the decent, hardworking people?
I expected that, my friend. But don't think you can fog up my brain with that magic word, the people. Not anymore. Just because there is a mass of organisms with the human shape, they do not automatically constitute a people. That honor has to be earned. Nor is one automatically a man simply by having human shape and living in a house and feeding one's face and agreeing with one's neighbors. No, that right also has to be earned. Now, when I reached my conclusions about the springs...
You have no right to speak about
any human thing, Peter, to catch me on a word. I'm not going into the springs. When I became convinced of my theories about the water, the authorities moved in at once, and I said to myself, I'm going to fight them to the death because
I... What are you trying to make? You're a revolutionist. He's a revolutionist.
No, just a minute. Just a minute. Wait. No, I said to myself, I have the majority. And I tell you, my friends, it was a grand feeling because the reason I came back to this place of my birth was that I wanted to share my education with this town. I loved it so. So I spent months without pay or encouragement and dreamed up the whole project of the springs. And why? No, not as my brother says, so that fine characters could crowd our streets, but so that we might cure the sick. So that we might meet people from all over the world and learn from them and become broader and more civilized. In other words, more like men, more like a people.
You don't even like anything about this town, do you?
You're a revolutionist. Admit it, a revolutionist.
No, I don't admit it. I proclaim it now. I am a revolutionist. I am in revolt against the age-old lie that the majority is always right.
He's an aristocrat all of a sudden.
And more, I tell you now that the majority is always wrong and in this way.
You lost your mind, stop talking.
Was the majority right when they stood by while Jesus was crucified? Was the majority right when they refused to believe that the earth moved around the sun and that Galileo be driven to his knees like a dove? The majority is never right until it does right.
I want to state right now that although I've been this man's friend, and I've eaten at his table many times, I now cut myself off from him, absolutely.
No, wait, answer me this, please, one more moment. A platoon of soldiers is walking down the road towards the enemy, but every single one of them is convinced he is on the right road, the safe road. But 2 miles ahead stands one and only man, the outpost. Now, he sees that this road is dangerous, that his comrades are walking into a trap. Now he runs back, he blinds the platoon. Now isn't it clear that this man must have the right to warn the majority? To argue with the majority? To fight with the majority if he believes he has the truth? Before many can know something, one must know it. It's always the same. Rights are sacred until it hurts to use them. Now I realize that the cost is great, the inconvenience is great, the risk is great that other towns might...
Mr. Robinson,
now listen to me, the springs are poisoned!
What about the poison? I'm going to take you outside!
Get out of here!
Quiet! We will not have any violence here! Doctor, come down from there and give Mr. Office in the plan.
I'm not through yet.
Come down or I'll not be responsible for what happens.
I want to go. Come on, Tom.
I move the chairman order the speaker to leave the platform.
Sit down, Doctor.
Get off that platform.
All right, then I'll take this out of town newspapers until the whole country is warned.
You wouldn't dare.
You're trying to ruin this town. That's all ruining
it. But you are trying to build a town on a morality so rotten that it will infect the country and the world. If the only way you can prosper is this murder of freedom and truth, well, then I say it with all my heart. Let it be destroyed. Let the people perish.
Arrest him. He's a menace.
Quiet, please. I would like to submit the following resolution. The people assembled here tonight, decent and patriotic citizens, in defense of their town and country, because of Dr. Stockman, medical officer of the Springs, is an enemy of the people and of his community.
That's not true. We love this town.
You fools. You damn fools.
Is there anyone against the motion? Anyone against?
I am.
One. Anyone else? With all votes against one, this assembly formally declares Dr. Thomas Stockman to be the people's enemy. In the future, all dealings with him by decent and patriotic citizens will be on that basis. The meeting is adjourned.
Captain, do you have any room for us on your ship to America?
Anytime you say, Doctor.
Catherine, Fletcher.
Doctor, you better get on that ship soon.
Let's go out the back door.
No, no back doors.
Right this way.
I don't want to mislead anybody. The enemy of the people is not quite finished.
Get out of here!
My windows.
You don't realize. People don't like to be pointed out easily.
You've got neighbors, I suppose. I've left it for you.
What's this?
I don't know how I'm going to get any shopping done with everybody ready to bite my head off.
Well, what do you know? We're evicted.
No, no!
Yes, he hates to do it, but with public opinion...
Maybe we should have left the boys go to school today.
Now, don't you get all frazzled.
But the landlord is such a nice man. If he's got the girls off the town, he'll be ready to murder us.
Just calm down. Calm down, will you? Look, soon we'll go to America, and the whole thing will be like a dream.
But I don't want to go to America. Oh, when did this get torn?
Well, that must have been last night.
Your best pants.
Well, it just shows you, that's all. A man goes out to fight for the truth. He should never wear his best pants. Sold them up, and in no time at all, we'll be 3,000 miles away.
But how do you know it'll be any different there?
I don't know. It just seems to me that in a place that big, the spirit must be bigger. So I suppose they have a solid majority there, too. I don't know. At least there must be more room to hide there.
Think about it more, would you? I'd hate to go half around the world and find out we're in the same place.
You know, Catherine, I don't think I'll ever forget the face of that crowd last night.
Don't think about it.
I mean, some of them had their teeth bared, like animals in a paddock. And who leaves the men who call themselves liberals, radicals? The crowd lets out one roar, and where are they, my liberal friends? You know, if I walked down the street right now, I bet not one of them would admit he ever met me. And just... Aren't you listening to me?
Oh, I was just wondering what we'd do with this furniture if we went to America.
Don't you ever listen to me when I talk to you?
Why must I listen? I know you're right. Well, Petra, why aren't you in school?
What happened? What's the matter?
I'm fired.
They wouldn't.
Until 2 weeks from now. But I couldn't bear to stay there.
Mrs. Bus fired
her? I never imagined she could do such a thing.
It hurt her. I could see it because we've always agreed so about things. But she didn't dare do anything else.
Oh, well, the glazier doesn't dare fix the windows. The landlord doesn't dare...
The landlord?
Oh, yes, evicted, darling. My God, on the wreckage of all the civilizations of the world, there ought to be a big sign. They didn't dare.
I really can't blame her, Father. She showed me 3 letters she got just this morning.
From whom?
They weren't signed.
Oh, naturally. The big patriots, with their anonymous indignation, scrawling out the darkness of their minds onto dirty little slips of paper. That's morality, and I'm a traitor. What did the letters say?
Well, one of them was from somebody who said that he heard at the club that somebody who visits this house heard that I had radical opinions about certain things.
Oh, wonderful. Somebody heard that she heard that he heard. Catherine, back as soon as you can. I feel like I have vermin crawling all over me.
Good morning.
Oh, Captain, you're just the man I wanted to see.
I thought I'd see how you all were.
That's awfully nice of you, Captain. And I want to thank you for seeing us through the crowd last night.
Did you get home all right? We hated to leave you alone there with that mob.
Oh, think nothing of it. In a storm, there's just one thing to remember. It will pass.
Unless it kills you.
You mustn't let yourself get too bitter.
I'm trying. I just don't guarantee how I'll feel when I walk down the street with traitor branded on my forehead.
Oh, what's a word?
A word? It can be like a needle, Captain, sticking in your heart. It can dig and corrode like an acid until you become what they really want you to be. Really an enemy of the people.
You mustn't ever let that happen, Doctor.
Actually, I just don't give a damn anymore. Let summer come. Let an epidemic break out. Well, then they'll see who they drove into exile. When do you sail, Captain?
You really decided to go, Father?
Absolutely. When do you sail?
That's really what I came to talk to you about.
Why? Something happened to the ship?
You see, we can't go.
No, the ship will sail, but I won't be aboard.
No.
Were you fired, too? Because I was this morning.
Oh, Captain. You shouldn't have given up your ship.
Oh, I'll get another ship. It's just that the owner, Mr. Bitt, happens to belong to the same party as the mayor. And when you belong to a party, and that party takes a certain position, because Mr. Bitt himself is a very decent man.
Oh, they're all decent men.
Oh, maybe that's the place.
No, Mr. Vick is not like all the others.
He doesn't have to be. A party is like a sausage grinder. It grinds and mashes up every clear and independent butt until everyone comes out talking and thinking exactly the same.
If you're busy.
Well, not at all. You're just picking up rocks and broken glass. What can I do for you this fine, brisk morning?
Come inside, won't you, Captain?
Yes, of course. Doctor, I'd like you to finish our discussion.
I'll be with you in a moment, Captain. Oh, keep your hat on if you like. It's a bit drafty in here today.
Thanks. I believe I will. I caught a cold last night. That house was freezing.
Oh, I thought it was warm, actually. Suffocating, as a matter of fact. What do you want?
May I sit down?
At your own risk. A piece of the silent majority is likely to open up your skull. Now don't tell me.
Yes.
I'm fired.
The board met this morning.
There was nothing else to do, considering the state of public opinion.
You look scared.
I haven't completely forgotten that you're still my brother.
I don't doubt that.
You have no practice left in this town, Thomas.
I don't know. Everybody needs a doctor.
There's a petition going from house to house. Everybody is signing it. They pledge not to call you anymore. I don't think a single family will dare refuse to sign it.
You started that, didn't you?
No. Matter of fact, I think it's all gone a little too far. I never wanted to see you ruined, Thomas. This will ruin you.
No, no, it won't.
For once in your life, will you act like a responsible man?
Why don't you just say it, Peter? You're afraid that I'm going out of the town to start publishing things about the Springs, aren't you?
I don't deny that. Thomas, if you really have the good of the town at heart, you can accomplish everything without damaging anybody, including yourself.
What's this now?
Just let me have a signed statement saying that in your zeal to help the town, you went overboard and exaggerated. And put it any way you like, just so you calm and anybody who might feel nervous about the water. You give me that, you've got your job. And I give you my word, you can gradually make all the improvements you feel are necessary. Now that gives you what you want.
You're nervous, Peter.
I am not.
You expect me to remain in charge while people are being poisoned?
Time you can make all your changes.
Oh, 5 years? 10 years? You know your trouble, Peter. You just can't grasp the fact that even now there are some men you cannot buy.
I'm perfectly capable of understanding that. But you don't happen to be one of those men.
What do you mean by that, man?
You know damn well what I mean by that. Morton Keel is what I mean by that.
Morton Keel.
Your father-in-law, Morton Keel.
I swear, Peter, one of us is going
to lose his mind.
I don't know what you're...
Don't try to charm me with that professional innocence.
What are you talking about?
You don't know that your father-in-law ran around all morning buying up stock in Kirsten Springs.
Buying up stock?
Buying up stock! Every sheriff can lay his hands on.
Oh, I swear, Peter, I don't know what that has to do with me.
Oh, come now, come now, come now.
Oh, I really hate it when you do that. Don't just walk around gambling. Come now, come now. Tell me what you're talking about.
Well, then, if you insist on being dense, a man wages a relentless campaign to destroy confidence in a corporation. He even goes so far as to call a mass meeting against it. The very next morning, when everybody is still in a state of shock about it all, his father-in-law runs all over town, picking up shares at half their value.
Oh, my God.
And you have the nerve to speak to me about principles.
Now, you don't actually believe that I
don't believe what I see. And what I see is nothing but a man doing a dirty, filthy job for Morton Keel. And I'm telling you, by tonight, every man in this town will see the same thing.
Peter, you
can't... Now, you go to your desk, and you give me a statement denying everything you've been saying, or by God...
You're a low creature.
All right, then. You better get this one straight. If you're figuring on opening another attack from out of town, keep this in mind. The minute it's published, I'll send out a subpoena for you and begin a prosecution for conspiracy. I've been trying to make you respectable all my life. Now, if you want to make the big jump, there'll be nobody there to hold you back. Now do we understand each other?
Oh, we do.
Get the girl! What the hell's her name? What's down the wall? Scrub the floors! A pestilence has been here!
Morton.
Now, what have you done?
What's the matter with you? Do you have any idea what this makes me look like?
Is that them?
That's them, yes. Kirsten Springs shares. Very easy to get this morning.
Don't play with me.
What is it all about? What are you so nervous about? Can a man buy some...
I want an explanation, Morton.
Thomas, they hated you last night.
Oh, you don't have to tell me that.
But they also believed you. They'd love to murder you. But they believe you. The way they say it, the pollution is coming on the river from Windmill Valley.
Well, that's exactly where it is coming from.
Yes. And that's exactly where my tannery is.
Well, now, Morton, I never made it a secret that the pollution was tannery waste.
I'm not blaming you. It's my fault. I didn't take you seriously. But it's very serious now. Thomas, I got that tannery from my father. He got it from his father, and his father got it from my great-grandfather. I do not intend to allow my family's name to stand for the 3 generations of murdering angels who poisoned this town.
Oh, Morton, I've waited for this talk a long time.
I don't think you can stop that from happening.
No.
But you can. I bought these shares.
Oh, you've thrown your money away, Morton.
I never throw my money away, Thomas. These were bought with your money.
My money?
You probably suspected I might leave a little something for Catherine and the boys.
Oh, yes, naturally, I hope that.
I decided this morning to invest that money in some stock, Thomas.
You bought that junk with Catherine's money?
People call me Badger. And that's an animal that roots out things. I've lived a clean man, and I'm going to die clean. You're going to clean my name for me.
Oh.
Now, I want to see if you really belong in a straitjacket.
How could you do such a thing? What's the matter with you?
Now, don't get excited. It's very simple. If you should make another investigation...
Oh, no, I don't need another investigation. I know what I...
If you think it over and decide you want to change your opinion about the water...
But the water is poisoned. It's poisoned.
Exactly. Go on insisting the water is poisoned. With these in the house, then there is only one explanation for you. You are absolutely crazy.
You're right. I'm mad. I'm insane.
You must be. You're stripping the skin off your family's back. Only a madman would do a thing like that.
Morton, I'm a penniless man. Why didn't you tell me before you bought that junk?
Because I thought you would understand it better if I told you after. God damn it. I think you do understand it now, don't you? Millions of tons of water come down that river. How do you know the day you made your test there wasn't something unusual about the water?
No, I took too many samples.
How do you know? Why couldn't those little animals have clotted up only in the patch of water you souped out of the river? How do you know the rest of it wasn't pure?
It's not probable. People were getting sick last summer.
They were sick when they came here. They would have come.
But not skin diseases, intestinal diseases.
The only place anybody gets a bellyache is here. There are no carbuncles anywhere else in Norway. Maybe the food was bad. Did you even think of the food?
No, I didn't look into the food.
Then what the hell makes you so sure it's the water?
Well, because I tested the water and I
admit it. We're all alone here. You have some doubt.
Well, nothing is 100% on this earth.
And you have a perfect right to doubt the other way. You have a scientific right. And did you ever think of some disinfectant? I'll bet you never even thought of that.
Oh, no, not for a mess of water like that. You can't.
Everything can be killed. That's science. Thomas. I never liked your brother. You have a perfect right to hate him.
I didn't do this because I hate my brother.
Part of it. Don't deny it. You admit there's some doubt in your mind about the water. You admit there may be ways to disinfect it. And yet, you went after your brother as if the only way to cure this was to blow up the whole institute. There's hatred in that boy. Don't forget it. These have belonged to you now. So be sure. Be sure. Tear the hatred out of your heart. Stand naked in front of yourself. Are you sure?
What right do you gamble my family's future on the strength of my convictions?
But then the convictions are not really that strong.
I'm ready to hang for my convictions. But no man has the right to make martyrs of others. My family is innocent. Sell back those shares. Give her what belongs to her.
No one is going to say Morton Keel wrecked this town. You retract your convictions, or these go to charity.
Everything.
There'll be a little something for Catherine, but not much. I want my good name. It's exceedingly important to me.
And charity.
Charity will do it, or you will do it. It's a serious thing to destroy a town.
Morton, when I look at you, I swear to God I see the devil.
You!
Now, don't get excited, Doctor, please.
Too many intellectuals here.
Doctor, can we have just...
I've got nothing to say to you.
I want an answer right away. You hear? I'm waiting.
All right, say it quick. What do you want?
We don't expect you to forgive her attitude.
Your attitude was Prosperity!
All right, call it whatever you want.
Look, I've got a lot on my mind, so get to the point. What do you want?
Doctor, you should have told us what was in back of it all. You could have had the messenger behind you all the way.
You'd have had public opinion with you now. Why didn't you tell us?
I'm very tired. Don't beat around the bush.
He's been all over town buying up stock in the springs. It's no secret anymore.
So what about it?
Well, you don't want me to spell it out.
I really wish you would, Hofstede. I've had a very long
time. All right. Let's lay it on the table. I'll talk to you.
No, go ahead.
Doctor, in the beginning we supported you. We couldn't go on supporting you because, in simple language, We didn't have the money to withstand the loss in circulation. You're boycotted now. Well, the paper'd been boycotted too if we'd stuck with you.
You can see that.
Oh, yes, of course. But what do you want?
The People's Messenger can put on such a campaign that in 2 months you'll be hailed a hero in this town.
We're ready to go.
We will prove you had to buy up stock in the Springs because the management would not make the necessary changes required for public health. In other words, you did it for absolutely scientific, public-spirited reasons. Now, what do you say, Doctor?
You want money from me, is that it?
Well, now, Doctor...
No, don't walk around it. Doctor, if we started to support you again, we'd lose circulation for a while. We'd like you, or Mr. Keel, rather, to make up the deficit. Now, that's open and above board, and I don't see anything wrong with it, do you?
Remember, Doctor, you need the paper. You need it desperately.
No, there's nothing wrong with it at all. I'm not at all adverse to cleaning up my name, although for myself it was never dirty. I don't enjoy being hated, if you know what I mean.
Exactly.
Nice, Lexman. Will you show me?
Now, just 1 minute. There is one point I hate to keep repeating myself, but the water is poison.
Well, now,
just a minute. The mayor says that he will levy a tax on everybody to help pay for the reconstruction. I assume that you are ready to support that tax at the same time you're supporting me.
Doctor, that tax would be extremely unpopular.
Doctor, with you back in charge of Babs as medical officer, I have absolutely no fear that anything can go wrong.
In other words, gentlemen, you're going to clean my name for me so that I can take charge of the corruption.
But we can't tackle everything at once. One new tax? There'd be an uproar.
It would ruin the people.
But you don't intend to do anything about the water.
We have faith you won't let anyone get sick.
In other words, gentlemen, you need someone to blackmail into paying your printing bill.
We are trying to clear your name, Dr. Stockman. And if you refuse to cooperate... Well, if that's going to be your answer.
Oh, yes. Yes, go on. What will you do?
I think we better go.
No, I'd like you to tell me, the man 2 minutes ago, you are going to make him a hero. What will you do now that I won't pay you?
Doctor, the public is almost hysterical.
To my face, tell me what you're going to do.
Well, the mayor will prosecute you for conspiracy to destroy a corporation. And without a paper behind you, you'll end up in prison.
And you'll support him, won't you, Hopton? I want this from your mouth, this little victory you'll not deny me. Tell the hero, Hopton, you're going to go on crucifying the hero, are you not? You'll not be here until I get this from your mouth.
You are a madman. You're insane with egotism, and don't try to excuse it with humanitarian slogans. Because any man who dragged his family through a lifetime of disgrace was a demon in his heart. You hear me? A demon who cares more for the purity of a public bath than the lives of his wife and children. Dr. Stockman, you deserve everything you're going to get.
Mother!
Please, consider it, Doctor. It won't take much money, and in 2 months' time, I promise you, your whole life will change.
Mother!
What happened? My God, what's the matter? Something happened. Look at him.
I'm all right. It's nothing.
What happened?
Nothing, Papa, I swear.
What happened? Why aren't you doing school?
The teacher said we better stay home for the rest of the week.
The boys hit him?
They started calling him names, so he got sore and started to fight with one kid, and suddenly the whole bunch jumped on him.
Why did you answer?
They called him a traitor! My father is no traitor, but you didn't have to answer.
You should have known they'd all jump on you. They could have killed you.
I don't care.
Oh,
I'll kill them. I'll tell you what. And the next time I see one of them, I'll kill them.
Let me go.
He called you a traitor. Enemy.
Sorry. Can you go wash your face? Good day, gentlemen.
Let us know what you decide.
I've decided. I am an enemy of the people.
What are you saying, Tom?
To such people that teach their own children to think with their fists. To them, I'm an enemy. And my boy. My boys, my whole family, I think you can count as all enemies.
Doctor, you can have whatever you want.
Except for the truth. I can have everything but that. That the water is poisoned.
But
the people are poisoned. The children are poisoned. If the only way I can be a friend of the people is to take charge of that corruption, then I am an enemy. The water is poisoned. It is poisoned. It is poisoned. Now, that's the beginning of it. That's the end of it. Now, get out of here.
You know where you're going.
I said, get out of here.
What are you doing?
You're a fanatic. You're out of your mind.
What are you doing?
He wants me to buy the paper. By the public, by the whole pollution of the Springs. And they'll make a hero out of me for that. But I am not a hero. I am the enemy. And now you're first going to see what kind of enemy I am. I'm going to sharpen my pen like a dagger. You, all you friends of the people, are going to bleed before I'm done. So go, tell them to sign the petitions. Warn them not to call me when they're sick. Beat up my children. Never let power in the school again, or shall destroy the immaculate purity of the vacuum there. So go, see to the barricades, for the truth is coming. Ring the bells, sound the alarm. The truth is coming, and soon it'll be prowling like a lion in the streets.
Doctor, you're out of your mind.
Out of here.
Don't you say that to him.
Get out of here.
Mother.
I've had all the ambassadors of hell today, but there'll be no more. Shelterless and cavernless and place. They'll call for blood now. They'll whip the people like oxen. Get away from there, get away!
But the captain knows where we can get a ship.
No ships!
We're staying? But they can't go to school. I won't let them out of the house.
We're staying.
Good.
Oh, you must be careful. We must live through this. Boys, no more school. I will teach you and Petra will. Do you know any kids? Street dogs, hooky players?
Oh, sure.
Good. I want about 12 of them to start. But I want them good at ignorance. Absolutely uncivilized. Captain, may we use your house?
Sure, I'm never there.
Fine. We'll turn out not taxpayers and newspaper subscribers, but free and independent people hungry for the truth. Oh, Petra, that reminds me. You run to Grandpa and you tell him. Tell him as follows. No.
What do you mean?
I mean, my dear, that we're all alone. It's going to be a long night before it's dark.
Half the town is out.
What's going to happen, Tom? What's going to happen?
I don't know. But remember, you are fighting for the truth. And that's what makes you strong. We are the strongest people in the world. But strong must learn to be lonely.